Hey guys, welcome to another film study video. This time we're going to be looking at round 7 of the fight. And with that said, let's get straight to the fight. You see Maidana backing Floyd up to the ropes. Floyd is in a high guard position. He's moving laterally. He's just ducking under a punch. Just basic defense, basic movement around the ring. And now you see him get cornered in the ropes. And what does he do? He goes into his Philly shell defense. Maidana looks to come down to the body before going up top. And what does Floyd do? Well, Floyd, basically, the first right hook is to the body. It's behind Floyd's back. And then the next one gets caught by Floyd's gloves as he's covering for the left hook up top. And then he smothers Maidana. So, basically, just basic boxing defense. In the Philly shell defense, he kind of rolls, which makes the right hand go to his back. It misses, and then the left hook coming off of that right hand is caught by his gloves, and then they're broken up again. Floyd backing up. Maidana comes through again. His right hook. Floyd ducks under the hook, and he comes up top. Floyd keeps blocking the left hand as it comes up to the top. He hits Floyd in the body. That is a body shot. That's a good body shot from Maidana right there. What Maidana does here is he's looking for the areas. This is very smart from Maidana because he's looking at all the areas which are open on Floyd. Because of Floyd's defense is so good, he gives you so little to actually aim and to actually target on his body. So Maidana does a good job of finding the only spot which is available, which is, his left side, and hits it with a good body shot and tries to come over the top, which Floyd ducks and then goes to his body. So this right here, what you see Floyd do here, is something you'd have seen countless times by the likes of Sugar Ray Robinson, Sugar Ray Leonard, just countless times. How many times do you see Nicolino Loesch, if you know who these guys are? You see him duck underneath the right hand, the right hook coming over the top, and immediately fire a body shot and the left hook off of that. This combination punching, which is highly effective because he's doing everything. He's throwing all the punches which based on his body position are the most sensible punches to throw. As soon as he ducks underneath the right hand, look at the weight shift and where his weight is after he ducks his punch. It's on the right side of his body, right? So that's how he's able to load up on, look at his back foot, how he's able to load up and twist the hips to fire this body shot. And as soon as he does that, where's his weight shift? All his weight has shifted to the left side of his body after he twists and fires this body shot. So he comes through with a left hook and immediately peels off and tries to, control Maidana's head and feint, throw a jab at the end of it to confuse Maidana. So, because Floyd usually does, if you look at Floyd Senior's training videos, you see he always tells his fighters to finish all their combinations by throwing a jab at the end of it. That's just good boxing. And then Floyd throws this shot to the body at the back, which lands on Maidana's body. So that was just some good showcase of some skills there. Typical spear-like jab to the body from Floyd. He has the best lead jab. Well, the jab is always a lead. He has the best jab to the body in the game. You see him here once again. Many people don't give him credit for this punch. This punch slows people down. This punch keeps people off of Floyd. And it really does add up. Well, a lot of people don't realize what a punch to the stomach does to you. It really does take the wind out of you. And it can leave you in the later rounds. It can really leave you in a bad position. Here you see Maidana shoot his jab. Once again, Maidana has a very good jab for the kind of fighter that he is. I was surprised when I saw how good Maidana's jab, and Floyd was surprised when he saw how good Maidana's jab was. He has a very good jab for the kind of come forward type of fighter that he is. So he shoots his jab. Floyd pulls away from his jab. You notice that Floyd doesn't just pull away with his head facing forward. Floyd actually angles his head towards the left and pulls away, because then if the punch even made contact, then his face is, he's kind of riding the punch anyway. So even if it makes contact, he's riding the punch because he tilts his head, he changes head slots and towards the left. So even if the punch makes contact, he kind of rides the punch and reduces the impact of the punch. So as you see Floyd pull from the punch, he immediately comes back with his right hand. This is a typical pull counter from Floyd. How many times have we seen this punch? Once again, he's leaning in towards Maidana. Maidana shoots the jab. Floyd pulls from the jab and immediately counters him with a very quick right cross and left hook combination, which Maidana blocks the left hook. Okay, you see Maidana shoot his jab, and they continue to box in the middle of the ring. Maidana shoots his jab again. So even as he already tried this before, Maidana, you know, buys what Floyd is selling again. I mean, literally within seconds of doing it the first time, he does it again. But what else would you do? I mean, Maidana tries to use his jab to keep Floyd busy. And what does Floyd do? Floyd counters him off the jab every single time. You see it happen twice. Floyd pulls from the jab, hits him with that right cross again, and tries to come through with a left hook combination once again. And then Floyd goes down to the body. Maidana shoots his jab, which kind of catches Floyd a little bit. You really just have to say Maidana's jab is one of the things that keeps Floyd from, like, towards the later rounds where Floyd really started to get busy on Maidana, it was only due to Maidana's jab that Floyd couldn't get as busy as he wanted to be. Maidana has a very good jab. A lot of people don't give him credit for his jab. He has a very good jab. Here you see what I talk about all the time about stepping back. This shows you, finally, this is a bit in the film, in the fight, where you can see Floyd shows you exactly what stepping back does. You see Maidana try and come with some offense towards Floyd, right? You see him try and come with that overhand right to the head. Now, what does Floyd do when he steps back? Look at that. As Maidana tries to come through with the overhand right to the head, this is something that would have caught Adrian Broner clean on the head, because Adrian Broner doesn't know how to step back. So simple things like this. As he comes through the overhand right, Floyd steps back, jumps back, just hops back. And what does that allow him to do? He evades any punch. Maidana refuses to throw the punch because there's no point. Floyd is outside punching range because he stepped back. And now he, look what I said. When you step back, it allows you to evade a punch. What does it allow you to do? It allows you to counter off the punch. It allows you to see any other punches coming. So there you see Maidana himself stepping back from the punch. More fighters in the ring need to, just because you know how to stand there and block a punch, just because you've been trained on how to block punches, doesn't mean you have to stand there and block every punch. The more you want to stand and block a punch, the more opportunities you give to be countered or to be hit in some place you were not expecting, because you stood there trying to block a punch. You don't have to be there. Let's continue. You see Maidana shoots his jab again. Floyd tries to counter him again, but this time he sees the punch isn't there. He immediately checks himself. He immediately corrects himself. Resets. That's a good thing. He can immediately check himself as he's throwing a punch. Maidana shoots his next punch. He shoots his jab again. Floyd just kind of watches that go by and shoots his jab to the body. We continue. Again, Floyd checks himself. He doesn't throw the punch. He doesn't throw the counter right cross. He checks himself. They continue to box. You see Maidana, very smart from Maidana here. He comes down to Floyd's body right here. He tries to come down to the body. You see what Maidana is actually trying to do here is he's trying to set up his big overhand right. This is the kind of punch he was landing on Adrian Broner all night long. He would go down to the body and then come over the top with the overhand right. But look at this short left hook from Floyd. Look what it does to Maidana. Look at Maidana's face. It completely neutralizes Maidana's offense. As he's stepping in to punch, Floyd steps back slightly, takes a quick step back, and throws one of the sweetest short left hooks. It's a beautiful short left hook, which catches Maidana clean, catches him flush on the head. And Floyd peels away, changing the angle as he does so. Look at this. This section of film is just amazing. As Maidana is coming and doing the right thing, Maidana is trying to shoot the jab down to the body. He's doing the right thing. He's trying to set up the overhand right. Floyd takes a quick step back, shoots one of the best short left hooks. He has one of the best short left hooks in the game. Catches him clean. It's like a check hook, but it's not as much as a check hook as we've seen Floyd do before. He catches him clean with his short left hook, and then he peels off and changes the angle on the punch. And that completely neutralizes Maidana. Maidana's game plan there, which was to come over the top with the overhand right. Now you see Maidana come in again with a seeking jab. This is a very good probing jab for Maidana, which he uses to occupy people before he throws his big bomb to the top of the head. Okay, continue to watch. Floyd shoots his jab, tries to come over the top with a right cross. After shooting his jab, the right cross misses, and Floyd immediately uses that to set up a body punch with the left hook to the body. Right? Beautiful left hook to the body. And then what does he do every time? If you see what I keep saying, what does he do every time when he finishes that? He finishes his combination with the jab. Floyd Mayweather Sr. always likes his fighters to, whenever they finish a combination, and Jeff Mayweather does as well, whenever they finish a combination, he likes them to shoot like a jab or a jab feint or just stick their lead hand out when they finish a combination. It's just, you know, good practice, good best practices. You see Maidana continue to look for openings in Floyd's defense. In Floyd's defense, and as he does so, Floyd tries to counter him with a right hook, with a right uppercut. It misses. Maidana's swinging wildly. Most of these punches are missing. Most of these punches are being caught on Floyd's arm, shoulders, elbows. You know, Floyd is rolling this punch. This overhand right that comes here completely rolled by Floyd. Floyd catches the punch of the body there. This is not effective punching. You know, a lot of people think Maidana was doing good work on the ropes. He was, but also most of the time he was missing completely. Just blocked. Most of his punches are blocked, missing, or just not effective. See, this is completely caught by Floyd. Tell me how you're going to get points for something like this. You know, this is blocked by Floyd right there. That's a blocked punch that doesn't score any points. We continue to see what happens. He comes over the top. That punch misses again. Floyd rolls the other punch on the overhand right with his shoulder. Steps back, fades away from this left hook. All of this is missing. All of that just missed. Everything you saw there was missing. But this is Maidana here now with his forearms in Floyd's face. On Floyd's head, this is head control for Maidana. This is something a lot of people don't like, but I don't mind head control. Head control is a useful boxing tactic. It's an old school boxing tactic. There's nothing wrong with head control. There's nothing wrong with using your forearms in someone's face, in my opinion. That's just good boxing. That's smart boxing as far as I'm concerned. That's why I don't have a problem when Floyd does it. That's why I don't have a problem when Andre Ward does it. That's why I don't have a problem when Maidana does it. I don't have a problem. It prevents punches coming back. It's a good thing to use to control the other fighter when you're not throwing punches or when you are throwing punches. There's just nothing wrong with using your forearms in someone's face, in my opinion. Then you see Maidana come over the top. Floyd counters into the body every time. See, this punch here lands on the back of Floyd's head, so that doesn't count. But Floyd fires a good quick shot to the body and counters him. This is what Floyd is doing the whole fight. Loads of people are missing this. Everybody's looking at Maidana throwing these wild clubbing shots. Nobody's watching Floyd counter this guy constantly to the body on the ropes. When Floyd is infighting with Maidana on the ropes, he's just countering this guy to the body. Like, he's just countering to the body the whole time. Nobody even sees that. The ref breaks him up. They go back on the ropes again. It's just more infighting on the ropes, more ineffective punches. The ref breaks them up again.
They go back to the ropes again. And they land a couple punches. They're just fighting on the ropes. Here you see Floyd land a number of combinations. People say Floyd doesn't throw combinations anymore. After Maidana does some good work to the body over here, he does some good work to the body. What does Floyd do? Floyd kind of controls him. Look at what Floyd is doing here. Floyd is controlling his head, controlling Maidana, so he can open him up. This is beautiful boxing right here. A lot of people don't like this, but this is old school boxing tactics. Muhammad Ali did this. Your favorite fighters did this in the past, right? But now they have a problem when Floyd does it. Look, Floyd is holding Maidana. He's controlling Maidana's head. This is head control, just so he can open up Maidana for that short right hook. You see that? He controls his head so he can open him up for that short right hook to the head, followed by the left, which is followed by another right hook to the head, a left hook, and then he peels away. Beautiful boxing. Let's see this again. Floyd goes into head control. He's controlling Maidana's head and positioning it where he wants it to be. And as soon as he removes his hand from Maidana's head, as soon as he stops controlling Maidana's head, what does he do? He fires a short right hook, catches Maidana clean, comes back with a left hook, misses, goes back with a beautiful right hook to the head, a left hook which doesn't really land clean, but, you know, it's a combination punch, and then he peels off from Maidana. Beautiful boxing. And now they're in the middle of the ropes. This is where Floyd really wants the fight to be. And this is where Floyd really dominates Maidana most of the time. All right, so you see Maidana shoot his jabs. Very effective jabs. I keep giving Maidana compliments for his jabs because he really does have some of the best jabs Floyd has ever faced, really. I think one of the other people who had a very good jab was Oscar De La Hoya, who also had a very, very, very educated jab. Maidana has a great jab on him as well. Floyd pulls away from those jabs, kind of fades away from them, gets back on the ropes. More punches which completely miss. Floyd ties him up, no problem. Maidana shoves his forearm in his face. I don't have a problem with that. This was a bit excessive, so, you know, this is kind of excessive, but, you know, whatever. You know, head control is head control, but that is a little on the excessive side. Just a little on the excessive side by Maidana. But it's okay. You know, it's boxing. This is a martial art. This isn't this is a fighting sport. You know, it's not tea and crumpets. You know, it is a fighting sport. You are in the ring to hurt the other guy, so. All right, you see Floyd, once again, very elusive and disguised left hook. This is leading left hook, but Maidana covers up and blocks that, so he did well there. What you need to understand about Floyd's leading left hooks that a lot of people don't realize is, before he throws him, he always feints like he's going low to the body. If you go and watch, I might actually do a comparison video of Floyd Sr. and Floyd Mayweather Jr. Because if you watch the way they both throw their leading left hooks, you'll notice that they always stick the lead hand out, then they always drop their lead hand and feint low to the body. Always. And once they feint low to the body, most people will drop their guard because they feint low to the body and then they come over the top. This is how Floyd put down Juan Manuel Marquez. This is how Floyd catches these guys with these left hooks, because he feints low to the body. Okay, with that said, Floyd throws another left hook, catches Maidana at the top of his head. Once again, he finishes the punch by sticking his lead hand out, his jab hand. Just end the combination. It's always good to end a combination by just sticking your lead hand out. That's just good best practices for boxing. Just finish your combinations by sticking a jab. By throwing a jab, or just stick your lead hand out. Occupy the space. It's always a good thing to do. Maidana shoots his jab. Floyd pulls away from the jab once again. You see Floyd probing offense here. He's looking for openings in Maidana. He shoots his jab to the body once again. That punch is always there for Floyd. See, what people don't realize is Floyd's jab to the body is always there for Floyd. He's so quick with his jab to the body that he can land that punch whenever he wants, and that is a point scoring shot. So you people, you know, who know how to score fights, though, you need to realize that every time Floyd shoots his jab down to the body and makes contact, he scores a point doing that. So, you know, because it's a clean punch. Let's continue to watch. Once again, you see Maidana shoot his jab. Floyd pulls away from the jab, tries to counter him with the right and left combination. You see this happen all the time. Floyd always pulls from the jab and tries to come back with his right cross and a left hook. Maidana goes down to the body. You can see Floyd backpedaling all the way back to the ropes. Good defense here, how he escapes from Maidana. You know, Maidana is a very good puncher, but Maidana is kind of quick. So this just shows you how, you know, Floyd's good defense to be able to see those punches coming, roll under those punches, and try and come back with a counter. He ties up Maidana. We can continue to watch. Maidana, once again, tucks his head down, digs his head down, tries to dig Floyd to the body. It's blocked. Maybe some of it got through. Maybe. It looks blocked. And you see Floyd clinch up, tie him up. Once again, the infighting on the ropes is really not as effective as people think. It's not as effective as people actually think. Maidana is missing most of those shots. Here you see Floyd tap. He taps Maidana's head here. He kind of just shows him the lead hand. He shows him his jab, just so he can set up the jab down to the body. Beautiful boxing. This is smart boxing right here. He occupies Maidana's guard. Once again, he sticks his lead hand out, occupies Maidana's guard by showing him that lead hand to the body. This isn't necessarily a jab. This is more just a tap to the top of the head. He just taps him with the lead hand, occupies his guard, wants him to keep his hand up. What he's doing here is he wants Maidana to keep his hands up. So he's expecting like another jab or a left hook. And this allows Floyd the time to throw that beautiful lead jab down to the body. A jab to the body and step away. And look, he does it again. Right? He just shows Maidana the lead hand, shoots the jab down to the body. So effective. Because Floyd is so quick, he can get away with this. Because he confuses you, you don't know what's coming next. He throws that. And he lunges in with his lead jab, going to the left. See, what he does here is he throws that lead jab, and look where his back foot goes. As soon as he throws that lead jab, look at the movement of his back foot. This is old school boxing right here. He's throwing that lead jab to the body, and he's moving at the same time. There's a lot of fighters who simply cannot punch and move at the same time. Floyd is throwing that lead jab, and he's moving to the left all the while he's throwing that lead jab. He's moving to the left at the exact same time. Such that by the time he's finished throwing the lead jab, look where he is. Look where he is. Most people don't even, like, they just miss this completely. He shows him his lead hand so he can confuse him and set up the jab to the body. But look at what he's doing as he's jabbing from Maidana to the body. He's circling to the left the whole time. And by the time he finishes the lead jab, he's in a completely different position from when he started the lead jab. From when he started the jab to the body. He's in a completely different position. That's beautiful boxing. And what does he do? He sticks his hand in Maidana's face, his lead hand in Maidana's face once again, to confuse Maidana. And Maidana's not expecting this right hand to the face. This is beautiful boxing, look. He puts his hand out, he sticks his lead hand, he just shows him his lead hand, and then he comes over with a quick right cross to the face, peels off immediately, shoots the left hook, and this is a very short right cross to the face. Like I say so many times, Floyd throws some of the best short punches in boxing. Just look at the hip rotation as he throws this punch. People talking about technique. If you want to talk about punch technique, look at the way he throws this right cross here. Look at his back foot off the ground as it should be. Look at his hips twisting. Look at how he dips slightly on his left, leg. Right on his left side, look at how he dips slightly on that side. This is the perfect technique for throwing the right hand. Perfect technique. Alright guys, I think that's enough. I'm probably going to stop the video now. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And on to the next.
So a strong round for Floyd Money Mayweather in what has been a terrific fight thus far. The main event here at the MGM Grand.